Put my chick inside some Louis and some Valentino. Put my bro inside some Gucci and some new machino. They want my money like it's a casino.
Let's go back to New York. What do you say are the differences or similarities
to New York and London?
Would you say it's very similar?
Do you know what it is? Let me tell you this. I didn't like New York too much. Yeah. One thing I found was that it was too money hungry. Okay. Like, I find, like, I compared two different places, New York and, let's say, Dubai and London, okay? Three different places. In Dubai, like, it's literally, like, almost like slave labor. People are, they're getting paid so little money. I think, like, people, I don't know how much, but it's just so ridiculously low. But what the service, top tier. I find like they will give you service for the sake of giving you service. Yeah. And they actually like probably enjoy doing or whatever. In New York, you find like they're just giving you service to get money out of your pocket. Yeah. They're trying to squeeze as much money from you everywhere you go. Everybody's asking for a tip.
Yeah.
Everything. Like, so it's like, it's not a nice feeling. Yeah. And with London, it's kind of like, it's in the middle. Yeah. Sometimes they do it for the, like, the nice, sometimes they're trying to just go about their day.
Yeah.
In London, London, I find is, you know, London's money hungry if you make it money hungry.
Yeah.
But it's not, like, truly inherently money hungry, but New York is money hungry.
Yeah. What Miami? How was Miami compared? Is that just different?
Miami different? Was like party holiday vibes. Miami was party holiday vibes, but it was still like they were just living. They were just in the moment living. Like, so I said I couldn't live in New York. Could I live in Miami? I don't think I could live in Miami because it's too much of a like a party vibe. Yeah. Just too much of like. Nobody's really doing nothing. Well, from what I've seen anyways, nobody's really doing nothing. Everybody's just kind of just living. A lot of people are just there on holidays as well.
Yeah.
But yeah, man, could you live anywhere else apart from England actually, or London?
Anywhere, I'd say there's London. Dubai, I would definitely like to live there for a few months to a year.
Yeah.
But full time, nah, I wouldn't
Why
say.
Not?
The reason is, it's just that, I just think London's just home, it's the heart. It's
yeah.
It's just a city of hustling. Dubai, I feel like it's a little bit too fake. I don't know how long that oil money is going to last.
That's true. The country's in a lot of debt as well, from what I've heard.
Yeah, so with Dubai, I definitely feel like you should go there just to experience it. Talking of which, what's the plan for Dubai? Is that the next move for the next couple of years?
Do you know what it is? Why I'm going there is that I felt like, it's just something for me to get away from London.
Yeah.
And the other thing with you, you're born and raised in London.
Yeah.
I'm not from London. I was born and raised in Dublin. Well, I was born in Nigeria, raised in Dublin, moved to London.
Yeah.
And I feel like I've done everything. I want to go to the next level. I want to elevate myself. I said, I want to go to a place where I feel like you never want to be in a comfort zone for too long. And I feel like I'm getting comfortable in London.
Yeah.
I want to go to a place nearby where I feel small. Because I like being the underdog. I like having to try to fight to the top.
Yeah.
I'm not saying I'm at the top now. I'm not saying I'm anywhere near the top.
Yeah.
But I feel like I'm comfortable. Like I'm, I don't like look out. Like I drive through London. I feel like, yeah, this is me. I want to go. I want to feel uncomfortable.
Yeah.
I want to be shaken up a bit. I want to go places and feel broke. Yeah. Like that broke feeling is what drives
me.
Drives me to hustle. You know what I'm saying? It's what kind of drives me to push on to the next goal and try to take it to the next step. Does that make sense? Why I wanted to go there, I felt like, you know, it is fake.
Yeah,
it's fake. That's one thing I realized. Social media is like, it's a bit fake.
And I've even been there, and I noticed in pictures you see it looks nice, but around the corner it's some dusty
places. Yeah, like I said, back a lot of the employees that work there, they could work like 12 hours a day, 6 days a week, and they're getting like 500 USDs a month.
Yeah,
so I'm saying it's crazy, but. You have to thank your blessings that we're not in that scenario. So like I said, yeah, for me, it's the next step. And it's like, it's fake, but if you're real to yourself, honest to yourself, I think you can make it there. And I feel like the way it's designed, if the government and the country still keeps its infrastructure right, I think a lot more influencers will move out there.
Yeah.
And a lot more people that are kind of making money online or making money not in a statutory location would be there, because the sun is, you have the sun, you have the beach, you have kind of freedom, you can decide to let's have paradise today, and you can lock yourself in your room and work all day.
Yeah.
So it's like some days in London, especially in London winter, it's cold, it's rainy, it's groggy. And then one thing about Dubai, I'd say safe.
Crime
has about one of the lowest crime rates in the world. You can leave your phone here and go anywhere you want to go and you're
come
cool.
Out with your jewelry.
Yeah, you come out with your jam. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like sometimes in London, like I might go places like Bagel King, I've taken my watches, taken my rings. You know, like, talking my shit, like, you know, saying, you have to kind of look over your corner, and, like, it's not.
Yeah, it's not too, you can be well on them side.
Yeah, so, like, so when I'm in that kind of places, I can be free to.
Yeah, talking of which, what would you say, just for those watching, what would you say are things that people that want to, you know, gain wealth and be successful, they have to look out behind themselves?
To look out for?
What should they look out for? Is fake friends, you know, people scheming you? What would you say? Was there any spirits for you?
I've had people rob me. I had people close to me, like, rob. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's like more manipulate you to get money. So I say what you want to look for if you want to actually start, like, when you do start making money, if you want to start making, the first thing, if you want to start making money, like I said, invest in yourself. Focus on you. You have to be greedy. Yeah. You really have to be greedy. Focus on.
Yeah, greedy with your time.
Greedy with your time. Yeah.
Before you help anyone else.
Yeah, like you have to be, you have to isolate yourself from, and you know, it's hard. It's hard to, like, leave some of your friends behind. Do you know what I'm saying? It's like, it's hard to leave people that are in a different mind space or a different pattern of life than you are. Like, you need to make a decision of, I'm going to be successful. Mm-hmm. Then you need to work at it every single day. And when I mean work at it, you need to read books. Mm-hmm. You need to look at people that are successful and actually listen to the words they say. Yeah. And actually, like, it's like, bro, don't just listen to what I say. Listen to what I say. Then go listen to what other successful people say on YouTube. And like, you see the correlation. Like, a lot of people are saying the same thing. And when you see, like, okay, cool, these are what these people are saying, let me start incorporating this into my life.
Yeah, sure.
So it's like, you need to get rid of, like, environments that you don't want. It's like, I don't want to be mean or belittle anybody, but if you're, like, living in a place or in an area that you feel like this is not where I want to be in the next 10 years, you need to find a way to get yourself out of that area.
Yeah.
Get yourself, like, I don't want to say out of the hood, but try to come out of them areas.
Yeah, yeah.
That's one thing with university. That's why it helped me. I have a degree. I have a first class business honors in business and finance. I've never used my degree. However, it was really important I got that degree because
yeah.
I made the friends to lead me to where I am today.
Yeah.
I got out of my comfort zone. If people knew, I'm from Jobstown in Tyler. If you guys want to do your research where that is, it's rough.
Yeah.
So like I took myself out of that environment and I took myself in a more in a university environment. I stayed at university and I was just kind of watching other stuff and it's kind of like I have my own place, so I'm in my own zone.
Mm.
And I worked to myself, I worked to my life and built my life how I want to build it. And then it worked. So that's one thing I say, build your own life. And it's possible. It's really, really possible. Really, 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 really possible. Like, you have to be, and you need to go, even if you can't afford to, like I said, you people are from London.
Yeah.
Like, let me ask you this. Before you turn 18, before you start getting a little bit of money, how many times did you go Mayfair?
Twice, once, like, man. Like, throw Mayfair was like, you'd be snapping it. Like,
do that. Like, if you're, if, like, all the 16-year-olds, walk around Mayfair, walk around expensive places
just to get
the environment, yeah, just to get the feel.
Yeah,
like,
build yourself in there.
Yeah, like, I remember I used to go around Canary Wharf and just walk around Canary Wharf.
Yeah.
Just walk. I remember I used to say, like, I just like this place. And eventually I got my office in Canary Wharf. Eventually I moved around Canary Wharf. I moved in Canary Wharf. I moved around Canary Wharf. I'm literally still close to Canary Wharf. And I used to just, when I was younger, I used to just like them. I went to Canary Wharf one time and I just felt like, this is me. I don't know what it is about this place, but I love it. I like it. It's clean.
Yeah.
It's prestige. It's what the lifestyle I want to build for myself. And I indulge myself into it. So that's similar with Dubai. As much as you say Dubai is fake, it can be prestige.
Yeah.
And it shows, like, there's an element of wealth there.
Yeah.
I want to delve myself into that and kind of, like, look at the people there. And, like, I want to bring myself to the same feeling I had when I was a 20, 19-year-old. Yeah. And had that same grind and that same hustle of feeling, like, feeling little again.
Yeah, I want to just quickly ask.